I am David Attenborough.
Fuck you.
And this is Todd and Nietzsche.
Fuck
Todd and
you.
Nietzsche. Todd and Nietzsche.
I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling. 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 I sell.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Go fuck yourselves. Go fuck yourselves.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Go fuck yourselves. That's right, folks.
I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling. 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 Barrel rolling, barrel rolling. I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling. I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling. I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling.
Because I'm not going to have the lexicon out there for my name, JWE Revelation News, of having a small fucking dick. I don't. I have a normal size Eastern European slack. I have slack. Shanny, do I hang a bit?
You hang a bit.
Do I flop?
You flop.
See? I got floppage, folks.
Hot damn! Hot damn!
Shanny, you're not a Christian. You're a whore.
I have slack.
Hot damn! Hot damn!
Can't even be honest with yourselves. That's sad.
Because I'm not going to have the lexicon out there for my name, JWE Revelation News, of having a small fucking dick. Small fucking dick.
Jason.
Small fucking dick. Small fucking dick.
He's got bigger feet than you.
But yeah, you have to say that. Like,
I'm sorry.
Yeah, just fucking leave it alone. I don't want people to know that.
Jason, chill out.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Go fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Go fuck yourself. That's right.
I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling. 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 I sell barrel rolling, barrel rolling.
Your arguments are stupid.
Free, I can go out and kill that motherfucker that I don't like right now.
Fuck your goddamn motherfucking hoe!
Can you say it? Say it right now for me.
Fuck you. You're evil fucking woman!
So good night, everybody, and fuck off. Fuck off.
Hello, 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 beautiful creatures of the internet. I'm your armchair quarterback, Mango Jones. Do I sound like shit? I feel like shit. Small human, what did we say about the fire truck? Can you take it in there, please? Thank you. So today, on our list, we have two videos from Boglum Chronicles. They're the latest in the Cobes updates. We have an old Shanny video from Fundy Archives. We have Tony Chase from, well, Tony Chase. And Kate is gonna cook something. I saw like 5 seconds of it and I was like, yeah, we'll watch it today. Okay. So let me do the spiel. We'll say hi to the folks. We'll get into this shit. Hold on, you guys, just 1 second. As always, in the description, you'll find links to the stream purse. I'm on the shared stream yard with. You'll find links to the Petty Fam. You'll find links to Tito and Yato. Tito is funnier than Yato. You'll find Mango's master list of U.S. resources with everything from LGBTQIA+ resources to domestic violence resources to reproductive health resources and beyond. Need help finding a resource? Hit me up. I'll see what I can do to help, but there's no guarantees. Pinned at the top is small human and Mango stuff. Today's goal is to reduce that PayPal pool as much as possible. It would be greatly appreciated. If not, well, it's your money. Do with it as you please. All right, so spiel over. Let's say hi to everyone. Brainless, of course, being first because he had StreamYard open. Because once again, the stream pers are all on a shared StreamYard because we are awesome like that. Didn't you know? Hello, hello, Mari. I was about to go to sleep. I'll keep the stream on. Speak in your ASMR voice. I don't pull that voice out too often. I don't think today is one of those days. Hey, hey, Billy Boy Blue. Long time no see. A Mango stream that you can attend. Yes. It's wonderful. It's wonderful. Hello, hello, Hillbilly Jim. Hashtag RIP subreddit. Yes. RIP to the subreddit. She will be missed. Just a great source. Hello, hello, Shaw. My afternoon entertainment right on time. Yes, yes, it is. Even though I'm late. ACT, you despise this new YouTube layout. I haven't noticed too much of a change in like the last week or so, but I bet that it's one of those things that's going to like gradually roll out. So, hello, hello, no one really matters but cats. Hope you're doing well today. Nay, Reaper. Hope you're all doing well, good, and very fatigued from physical therapy. Today had a rough day. I'm sorry that your day was rough, but I am glad that you were able to attend physical therapy. And, you know more than anyone else that the hard work does indeed pay off. Let's see, we got Brandon the Trash King. I wanted to learn about the fire truck. Oh, well, it's the Little People brand fire truck. They go as fast as they can. Firefighters love to lend a helping hand. I know all of the songs by heart. Same with the dump truck songs. Hello, hello, Griffin Doggo. Did we hear Jessica might be a sicko? Yes, I did hear that Jessica might be a sicko. For those that want to see it, if you go over to Jessica Messica's channel on her community tab, there is a screenshot of a review of a Home Depot that Jessica, Naked and Laughing, used to work at. And it's pretty wild. But yeah. Yes, Cobes did get another strike, and we are going to talk about that. Why RIP subreddit? Did something happen? Oh yeah, like three different King Cobra subreddits got banned. It was a sad day. Oddly, it was right after Jessica was going on her stream about how much she hates the subreddits. So, suspicious. Hello, hello, Harry Warp. My youngest has the Little People school bus. Yeah, Small Human has the animal train, the regular train, the fire truck, the dump truck. I think he still has a school bus, a taco truck, and the Little People school. Little People are, like, one of his special interests. So, I do not mind the Little People stuff. They just, the songs get stuck in your head, man. Just get stuck there. Oh, also, Kiwi Tapes dropped a Shanny / Rev video. A lot of mistakes. Really? I will have to watch that video and then see what was not right and shoot them a message. With, of course, you know, proof. I don't like correcting mistakes without proof. All right, so we have stuff to talk about. And the first thing that we're going to do, we'll do a Cobes video, then we'll check in with, like, Tony Chase. And then we'll get back to Cobes. That way there's a nice little breakup in things. But the first video is Cobes gloating about his subreddit getting shut down. Because, of course he would. Let's see. Also, hello to all of the lurkers. Anyone that might catch this on replay, you're all amazing and wonderful. There it goes. And of course, once again, this comes to us from Boglum Chronicles, who puts in all of the hard work to edit everything. Hello, hello, Aline Ebony. Hope you're feeling better. Thank you. I'm getting there. If I fall asleep, I apologize. You're all good, Reaper. You're all good. If I only comment when I have something to add, am I lurking? Schrodinger's lurk? I'm not sure. I don't know. But yeah, let's get started.
What up, YouTube? It's your boy, King Cobra. We chilling like rock star villains. So two of my troll King Cobra subreddit pages got deleted, and the trolls are pissed. Then they made the ones that didn't get deleted private because they're pussies and they're afraid to lose their troll pages or wham. I got one stupid comment on Facebook, too.
The editing on these is always fantastic. Hey, Forever Fetus Toenail. Lovely to see you. But, yeah, of course they were pissed that the subreddit was gone. I was pissed that the subreddit was gone. The subreddit is a great place to discuss things. You know, without having to actually sit through, like, 5 hours of one of your videos. I got some yummy strawberry and red apple flavored hard candy from a local store called Lofty Pursuits. Make their own hard candy in-house. That's fucking dope. That is dope. Hey, Alibis. I fucking love his wahs. And today's wah is all about... Well, he's gloating this time, but like... Hey, Arxinium. Lovely to see you. But, like, we're allowed to be disappointed that the subreddits have been yeeted. And the other ones being put on private isn't really a big deal because, like, all you have to do is request to join. And the mods can approve you and get you in. It's a very simple concept. There's a lot of private subreddits.
Why should we watch your content? Because if all you're going to do is get your fan pages deleted, and it's like, first of all, the majority of that crap was not fan related. These people are organized trolling me, and they do anything they can to make my life miserable, and I say fuck them, and I keep making videos. My trolls have now gotten me kicked out of 2 apartments. Granted, certain circumstances didn't help that situation, but we're not going to get into that.
By that, do you mean Jessica? Jessica didn't help the situation? Jessica was kind of the nail in the coffin? Is that what you mean? I think that's what you mean. You can say it. Hey, Stangdoll. It's all right that you're a little bit late, Billy and Portly. We're just getting started. Things are getting going. Hey, Coyote. John, how you doing, handsome? No. That was definitely Jessica. Jessica got you removed from the apartment. Also, the they don't necessarily do organized attacks, my guy. In fact, most of what the subreddit was full of was people speculating or posting clips being like, oh, Jessica confirmed what we already thought. He did get a trailer. Or Jessica's being fucking weird. Why is he with her? Like, it was a whole bunch of that. No one organized attacks on you. People just do what they want to do. Also, how did the trolls make it so you smoked and painted and used woodworking equipment inside? They did not. Well, I guess, excuse me. Technically, the trolls did cause him to use woodworking equipment inside because someone got him a lathe. So that was, you know, a thing, but what are you going to do? It is a fantastic pause screen, Mari, and I am definitely going to take a screenshot of it. Working on good things, got a sale this weekend. Ooh, fuck yeah. Get it, John. But yes, let's screenshot this. It's a wonderful image. Really says all you need to know about Cobes. Let's do that. There we go. Got it. All right.
You're overreacting.
I said you could do whatever you fucking want!
And I appreciate that. I don't know why you're getting mad. I really.
Because you keep talking shit about me and
making I'm not talking shit about you.
You keep asking me to cut! I do what you want!
I give a fuck. Would you please stop?
He gives a fuck. Please stop. Like, girl was going fucking crazy. Girl was going absolutely insane. So, of course, that's going to get him in trouble. What? What do you expect?
I said, I wish I would shut the fuck up too. How about you listen? Thank you. I'm not screaming, leave me the fuck alone. Just like I got like 1 hour of sleep yesterday, I still try, like, I'm trying to get to sleep, and now you bust in, fucking wake me up, so. Did I say bitch? You need to listen. Nobody said that. I said you need to listen.
Okay, the main factor of that would be, you know, they've harassed the conquistadors nonstop for like the last 6 years now, and it's just disgusting. And I honestly want to say I'm sorry for that, because the management here doesn't deserve that. Maintenance doesn't deserve it. And the new owners were just like, nope, they were not informed the full situation. Like, nope, we don't care. No one told them, hey, this dude's got Asperger's and.
Oh my god, internet. Quit being weird. Like, I am in the living room. I love when that happens. But the trolls leaving weird reviews isn't going to do very much. Like, at all. Also, hey, Vicarfly. He is going to kill himself with that poison. Yes, yes, he is. He absolutely will. Because he just doesn't stop. He never stops. He doesn't know what his limit is. Hey, Mango, can you tell me if Asperger's come with pickles?
Pickles. 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 Pickles.
Pickles. Pickles. Naturally, if you guys want delicious homemade pickles, hit up Security Monitor Lizard at postaliguana@gmail.com. Hey, Aaron, how you doing today, bud? Hope you're doing well.
And, well, his internet trolls are assholes. It's all good, though. It's what it is. It's what it is. Did you get some of that?
Oh, my God. Spectrum must be in the neighborhood working.
Fire mead. All the ingredients that mixed into it softened the burn and made it stronger. Much stronger. I think it's fucking hilarious because now the trolls are going to be throwing a fit going, it's not fair. What are beautiful King Cobra JFS subreddit troll pages? Oh. They've got me fired from 2 jobs. They've literally gotten me kicked out of 2 apartments. What they'll do is they will harass where I work and where I live to cause their own sort of what they call entertainment. But the only people that are entertained by it are these miserable sick fucks who have no lives. Yeah, it's fucking hilarious.
It seems like you getting fired from jobs would be a you problem. That feels like a you problem. Not a troll problem, a you problem. You getting kicked out of apartments also feels like a you problem because you're not very aware of how to live around people. And playing Tiny Tina's Wonderland, one of the guns has an infinite mag but a heat meter. One of the ways it cools down is that your guy brings out a water pistol and sprays the other gun to cool it. That's actually pretty fucking awesome. I haven't played Tiny Tina's Wonderland yet. I need to. Spectrum sucks. I have them too and hate it. Yeah. Yeah, but what are you going to do when you have limited options in the sticks? But no, these are all you problems, Copes. Like, one of the things about being an adult is taking accountability. Like, being held accountable, taking personal responsibility for your shit. I am also autistic, and you know what I do? Take responsibility and hold myself accountable for shit. It's a wild concept, but it's helped me out a lot. Hello. Hello, Knitting Gamer. I have a question. Who's been streaming longer, Shani or Cobes? Shani's been doing stuff for a long fucking time. Over a decade. So she actually got started on all of this shit like way back in the day. Pretty sure it was Shani. Pretty sure Shani has been streaming longer. Hello, hello, Sydney. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you. But yeah.
Yes, because then when they mass flag my channel for shit, and the algorithm being run by a YouTube computer and not some actual workers, YouTube makes enough money that they can pay people a little bit of cash to police YouTube instead of some stupid computer, but I digress. But no,
yeah, except that's the thing, though. They do have people. So what'll happen is when something gets flagged a bunch of times, or it's flagged for the right things, the YouTube bots will review it first. And then if something is amiss, at least by the bot standard, then you'll get a notification about it. After you get the notification about it, you can appeal. You have the option to appeal. Like, it's a thing. Hey, J-Mag, how you doing? I'm trying to think way back to the earlier days of DP when they were talking about how Shani thought the moon was fake. Yes, that was Shani they were talking about. She said the moon is a hologram. And that was back when, that clip comes from when they were doing like G Plus hangouts. So it's been a long while. People used to be like, Google Plus was a dead platform. No, plenty of people used it. Plenty of people were involved with it. You just needed to know the right groups of people. It's just, it's incredibly frustrating, Cobes, that somehow all of this shit doesn't fall on your shoulders. It's always on someone else. Always. Always.
Funny because my YouTube trolls will sit there and mass flag my my videos and get me YouTube strikes. They abuse the system constantly. And when I go to flag their channel once, nothing happens. So I just pretty much block and ignore the channels. Just now, if you go to Google King Cobra JFS subreddit and click on it, it says this page has been banned. So the King Cobra JFS, that's what's up page, got banned, which I didn't know that existed. So, but the main King Cobra JFS subreddit page was just, ugh. That's where the whole thing started. And then it branched off into a bunch of other fucking nasty subreddit pages that are literally dedicated to bullying me, finding out my new addresses, and trying to get me fired from my jobs and shit like that. It's just...
Once again, no. No. Like, the main subreddit, the one that I love to peruse, they would, once Jessica confirmed that you're getting a trailer, they took screenshots from like random videos and movies and TV shows of trailer parts. And they were joking about it. They weren't trying to find you and where your new location is. No one has to put in that much effort. Primarily because we have Naked and Laughing, aka Jessica, who opens her mouth and says all of the things. So, yeah. If you don't want the trolls to know where you are, maybe just don't tell her. I will just browse cow stuff on Kiwi Farms. Even if it gets taken down off the Surface web, I have the Onion link and can access it on the Tor browser. Nice. I check out the farms every now and then, but Usually it's only when someone else brings it up, I'm like, ooh, that's interesting. Let me read about that.
Wow. I choose not to engage with my trolls outside the internet, which means I already won and I'm inside their fucking head. Otherwise, they wouldn't be so dedicated to harassing me in the first place. Here's the best part of it, YouTube. I don't go out of my way to get my trolls kicked out of their shit, you know what I'm saying? Because the majority of my trolls probably live in their mom's basements. And that's why they try to get me kicked out of my apartments. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is, YouTube. As soon as they found out Jessica was coming to Casper, they tried to get the second half of her flight canceled so she couldn't get home. But that got resolved real quickly. These people are fucking assholes. That's identity fraud, by the way.
No. It's not really at all, especially because the ticket was paid for by not you or Jessica. And as it stands, it really feels like Jessica's the one that canceled it, because when things aren't going her way and something fucks up, she's generally very, very pissed off. And she was not pissed in the least about not having her flight back. And yeah, Hillbilly Jim is right. We'll just wait for Jorp to tell on himself. He does it every time. He does. He tells on himself all the fucking time. Naginyu Farms, as in human organ farms. Good morning, Mango and Dr. Small Human Esquire. Ah, yes. Dr. Small Human Esquire. Are we doing doctor stuff or legal stuff today? All right. He just accidentally hit himself in the face with his shoe, so I say we're doing doctor stuff today.
Trying to get a refund on the second half of that flight to a certain credit card because you have Jessica's comp number for her flights. That's fucked up. That is fucked up.
Thank you, Boglum Chronicles, for getting that and making it digestible. So, right now, what we'll do is take a very brief, like 1 minute long intermission. I will pull up a Tony Chase video and we will get going with that.
I do not believe that I actually showed anything of my body that was inappropriate by the standards of good taste, by YouTube's community standards. Now, I do love my body. Other people don't have to love my body. It's not their body, it's mine. And I decided to stand in the shower.
Ask me about my wiener!
Zehnder Wiener Schnitzel, we're all together now. With hamburgers and hot dogs, no more need to look around. Hamburgers and hot dogs, all together now. After Wiener Schnitzel, it's all together now. After Wiener Schnitzel.
And we are back. Thank you, Mr. Fat Photog, for that video. We love and appreciate you. So, this, of course, is Tony Chase. Tony Chase titled this video, "Working in the Entertainment Industry is a Job and Career." So, let's see what Tony Chase has to say about that.
And how you guys doing? This is important and reverent. The history and the entertainment industry, and me when I was a child celebrity, and all the movies and TV shows that I have been in, has to be acknowledged in reverence to. Some people think I was one of the hardest working actors and actresses in movie history when I was little. I mean, as a child celebrity, you know, because I was in a lot of movies and sang a lot of songs and did a lot of dance.
One day, if I ever find out what your actual name is there, Tony Chase, I would love to see what movies you were in as a child. I have a sneaking suspicion that it was home movies, and you counted that as being in the entertainment industry. But, you know. Also, hello, hello, Hooves. Long time no see. Hope you're doing well. The ocean is a soup. It's a very salty soup, but yes, the ocean is a soup. Oh. Hold on.
To be fair.
Corky's bits look more like a tater tot than a wiener. That's 100% true. I saw it in Shaw's Discord because Todd posted it. Thank you, Todd. At least it was in the right section. Damn, that was Segmento Jr. Ah, that was just Nick Bravo. Tony played Dorothy in Wizard of Oz.
So, you know, in reference to people trying to steal my history, people got to get ordered into court. Now, we're all protocols in the media of my identity for a lot of reasons. So nobody can steal my identity. So nobody can try to steal my career. So nobody can try to steal my money or property or land or my mother and father's estates. Those people need to get ordered into court, whoever they are. And in reference to the facts of history of other celebrities and their lifestyles and the fact of what their daily lives are like, or the fact of ballerinas or, you know, supermodels or actresses or, you know, career acknowledgments, as opposed to the types of situations that I've been held hostage in. Look at the history.
Ballerinas? Well, yes, ballerinas are part of the entertainment industry. They're completely different thing. I heard Corky is going to get another W from Dapperton. Yes. Yes, he is. He absolutely will be getting another W from Dapperton, which is really weird when we're living in a time where Corky is getting W's. I don't understand it. OMG, stop seeing all the its and thens, Mango. Look here, listen. It's not my fault. I choose to believe that it is not my fault.
And financial wealth. My parents was richer than a lot of people's parents. You know, there's the information, of course, in reference to trust fund information that I was supposed to have received, monies and lawsuits and insurance that I was supposed to have received, life insurance policies of my parents that I was supposed to have received, lawsuits in reference to the government injuring me, lawsuits in reference to the government allowing people to kidnap me from my mother and father's mansions in the past, all the history of all the violations of government. There's supposed to be lawsuits on everything against the government. And the monies I was supposed to have received from the Treasury every year in reference to when my father got murdered, that the government has never paid. But the facts of information are on record, too. And in reverence,
your father, Walt Disney? Because you said before that you're Walt Disney's child. I really need to sit down and try and piece together all of the stuff that Tony has said. Corky is just basically playing... Oh my god, small human. Corky is just basically playing Call of Duty as someone who generally sucks at Call of Duty, but is taking out all the noobs. Fair. It's a fair assessment. I am totally feeling Tony's choice of backdrop for his videos. A tiny Gap poster, an empty McDonald's fry container, are especially nice touches. Yes, yes they are. And up here we have Santa, who is going into a chimney. That is a motivational poster. We have a Captain America hat. There's quite a few things. There's a men's health magazine back there too. And the thing is, his background changes around a bunch because he'll add stuff and take stuff away. A little further down the wall, there's actually a knee brace box that he's stuck on the wall. Yeah. Who shares the sexy for Christ link a lot? If that's not hostile, I don't know what is. Yes, that is hostile. It's very hostile. Lol suits? I think he's trying to say the word law, but I could be wrong. I'm making my grandma's spaghetti sauce from her recipe as I listen. It's absolutely delicious. Ooh. I'm also going to be making bread as well. Fuck yeah. I need to make more spaghetti sauce sometime soon. Tony has multiple sets of parents. Everyone just splooged in a pile and it made Tony. Yeah, that also tracks. That tracks. For who Tony is.
To the Osgoode Slaughter lawsuit that my mother had filed against the government. Somebody has tried to say there's a political family that's been living off of that money. Because that lawsuit was a big lawsuit because the government was trying to deform my legs back then. And the government was trying to deform my body back then, back in the 80s too. So, you know, there was a big lawsuit in reference to attempts to murder against the government. And some government man's been stealing the money every fucking day since the first fucking day.
I mean, I knew the government was, you know, trying to steal his inches and lasering his cat and lasering his teeth. But I didn't know that they were trying to murder him. Why are they trying to kill you, Tony? Why would the government be trying to do that? Shani is also making bread because the yeast is building up and she won't get off the couch. So that heat will eventually make it rise. That is disgusting. Do you think Tony uses his card and doesn't understand that it takes the money out? I've heard of people thinking some BS. I don't know. I genuinely just don't know. But thank you, Tony. It was lovely to hear from you. I'm going to give you all a dance break to clear your mind some. And then we've got the latest Boglum Chronicles video. So, everyone, please enjoy having sauce on your pants.
Woo! Okay, that condom fucking reeks.
Say, I got sauce in my pants, goddammit. 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 Got sauce in my pants. Say, I got sauce in my pants, goddammit. Got sauce in my pants, goddammit. Got sauce in my pants, goddammit. Got sauce in my pants.
And I tell ya.
Well, say, I got pants. Say, I got
sauce.
You know, I got pants. You know, I got sauce. Got sauce in my pants. Got sauce in my pants. You know, I got sauce in my pants.
Some of this
sauce in my pants. Son of a bitch. Sauce in my pants, goddammit. got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants. Say I got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it. Got sauce in my pants, god damn it.
Got some of this, got some of this, got some of this, got some of this sauce.
Please go and subscribe to the Walnut Grove because they put out bops like that. And yes, Shaw, I know that you hate me and I love you too. Hooves, this has been going on for a couple weeks now. You are behind, my guy. Love you, Hooves. We also listen to Double D's, which we'll probably listen to Double D's after this. Mama Shaw wants me to send her the link. We love Mama Shaw. Mama Shaw is fucking great. But yes, we have the next Boglum Chronicles video because Cobes got another YouTube suspension. So let's learn about what's going on with that.
Facebook, it's your boy King Cobra. Although if you're friends with me personally, you know me as just Josh. So I got a 2-week ban from posting videos on YouTube.
Which means that Cobes is on strike number 2. Cobes is on strike number 2. Now, the problem with Cobes being on strike number 2 is that your strikes don't expire until 90 days after they go into effect. So, with him now having 2 strikes and having at least 2 more months before that first strike expires, if he gets another strike in that time, his channel will be terminated. So, he's going to have to, like, be on his toes and very aware of what he is doing and saying. Hey, hey, J Gamer. Hello, hello, randomly ignored 84. I was dozing off entering Dreamland and heard sauce on my pants. Ah. I'm so sorry, Mari. My bad. But yeah, Cobes is going to have to be, like, ultra vigilant about what he is doing and saying on his YouTube channel after the 2 weeks are up. Because he could lose his channel entirely. And if he loses his channel entirely, even though he'll probably come back, he won't be able to monetize. And he will get banned once he tries to monetize for a ban evasion. If you're wanting him to be aware, you are setting the bar way too high. I do have the bar set pretty fucking high, don't I? Do you think Cobes' dad would flag Cobes' stuff to try to get him off of YouTube? No, I don't think so. Clint's way too much of an enabler. I can guarantee the folks who appreciated the subreddit are considering taking the boy's big channel from him. Oof. That'll be interesting.
Because of a video I made roasting my YouTube trolls, which I think is kind of fucking ironic, because a lot of my fans are getting sick and tired of the lameoid trolls making these lame-ass YouTube, whatever, Reddit pages that are designed to troll the fuck out of me. They're sick of it. And like the King Cobra JFS subreddit got banned because people are, like I said, if you follow me on YouTube, you know what's up. And I was just talking mad shit on my trolls earlier because they know I'm right. And they know I'm right, otherwise they wouldn't have mass flagged this video. And what video did they flag? It was me using the Talking Tom app to roast my trolls.
Now, that's the thing. If a video gets flagged for something like harassment and bullying, and you get suspended over it and things like that, typically that means that it was not a false flag. There was reason to flag it. If no one flagged it and it just got picked up by the bots that, you know, check your content, especially on monetized channel, then it's just you not understanding how YouTube works. You've been here long enough. You're really close to 100K subscribers. Like, you should know how this works. I had a video up on a White Boy Rumble Rants that had been sitting there for a while. And suddenly one day I got an email letting me know, oh, hey, this video was removed for harassment and bullying. No one flagged it. The bot picked up on it. It is what it is. It happens. That's most definitely what's up, YouTube. Yes, it is. This is the second Talking Tom video he's gotten flagged. You'd think he'd stop using the Talking Tom app. You'd think, but he won't. Sauce is simmering for 2 hours. Love the smell. Oh, you're making me hungry.
Gonna pack me a little bit of Outlaw Lucky Lipper. I'm not gonna quit tobacco by any means, but as far as a tobacco substitute, the stuff with the Nick Safe and the fat cut gets the job done.
Quit wasting your money on it. It's stupid. Hello, hello, user two. Welcome in. It's lovely to see you.
They do come in pouches if you don't want to be messy with it. Tastes just like Mountain Dew. Now, YouTube does allow certain things on their platform.
A year or so ago, I got flagged on a copyright violation for a video I have had private for at least 10 years. Bots will bot. Bots will bot. They will scan all of your shit. And you never know when it's going to happen. Greetings! How are you, widows? Doing well today? But he's not wasting his money. That's his pay piggy's money. And Papa Nips. Yeah, that's true. It is the piggies and Papa Nips' money.
I've seen some pretty sexual shit on YouTube, Facebook. I have. I've seen some pretty raunchy shit on YouTube that nobody seems to care. So I'll give you an example. If YouTube sees Jessica giving me a kiss on one of my videos, my trolls mass flag the video and say sexual content, then they give me a strike. And when the strike's lifted...
Okay, the example that you're using is really fucking bad because she wasn't just kissing you on that video. She was doing some over-the-pants and under-the-pants stroking. And you were squeezing her tits and rubbing them. So, no, you weren't just kissing. If you're going to tell the story, tell the whole truth. because, yeah, that's going to get flagged for sexual content, probably by the YouTube bots. There's no reason for her to be giving you over-the-pants hand jobs on YouTube. That's gross. Just trying to make it to Friday, bros. Yeah, I feel that. Hey, quit hating on the rub mano and look at this on the pork rub mano and look at this graph. Oh, should I look at the graph? Let's look at the graph.
Look at this graph.
That was quite the graph. Hey, Drewzilla. Classy. Yeah, it was classy. Classy as fuck. Just kissing. Yeah, PT Ham, they were just kissing. You know, you should ignore all of the hand jobs and tit rubbing. Because it was just kissing. He got flagged for it.
You know what I'm saying? And Jessica comes back to see me. They managed to get her airplane ticket number and try to cancel the second half of her flight, committing identity fraud to fuck with her. And when that doesn't work and she gets home safely, the next thing that they do is, oh, I know, let's get Cobra kicked out of his apartments. My YouTube trolls have been harassing the apartment I live in nonstop for the.
Okay, when it comes to Jessica and the plane ticket, first of all, the pay piggy that bought said ticket knew what the confirmation number was, or what the flight lookup number was. They knew what that number was, and they could have done it, especially if they were getting it refunded back to their credit card, because they were the one that purchased it. Now, the other person that knew that number was Jessica. But you want to know what Jessica did when she was live streaming one day? She covered up her name on the ticket, but left that, like, at least she tried to cover up her name. Her name was still visible. And so was the flight lookup number. The trip lookup number was visible on the ticket in her hand on her stream. She showed it to the camera. Bless you, small human. Anyone could have looked it up, but not anyone could have canceled it. It's that simple. God, you're dumb. Google moderation team gives no fucks ever. No, they really don't. Did they find out who canceled the ticket? No, they did not. They did not find out. If you know the starting / ending city for a flight, you can sometimes figure it out. Yeah, but they wouldn't be able to call pretending to be Jessica, verify all of her information, and cancel her flight. Know what I'm saying? Only the pay piggy and Jessica would be able to do that, because the pay piggy knew all the information to be able to book the flight in the first place. And Jessica knows all that information because, well, she's Jessica. So, like, it could only go one of two ways. Yeah, her flight home got canceled. And then she ended up leaving, like, 3 days after she was supposed to. But it was just the way that she acted about it, I'm leaning towards it was her. Of course, this is just my theory because I don't know. But my theory is that she did it because she was way too calm about her flight being canceled and getting to spend more days with Joshy.
6 years. You know, and that doesn't work. And my fans are like, you know what? I'm sick and tired of watching Josh go through this crap. He doesn't deserve it. No human being deserves this unless you're an inhuman piece of shit, which I'm not. I'm a decent guy. I am a little eccentric, yes, but I digress. And then the King Cobra JFS subreddit gets shut down and the trolls lose their fucking shit. Because as I said on my YouTube channel, the King Cobra JFS main subreddit started off as a troll subreddit, which attracted more trolls. And these trolls were worse than the trolls on the main subreddit. And they're like, and then they want to act like they have morals. That's fucking hilarious. But then
they do have morals. A lot of them do have morals. They have values. They have standards. But even people with morals and values and standards find something to have a little bit of fun with. And making you rage is super fucking easy, so they're going to have fun with it. They're going to do things like send you random food orders that don't make sense. They're going to do things like send you fucking wood chips for your living room to turn it into a giant hamster cage. They're going to do things like send pig food when Jessica is over. Does it cost you anything? No. They're literally paying out of pocket to fuck with you. And you allow it to get under your skin. Hello, hello, Brainless. Welcome back. Jessica is quick to rage and a liar, so maybe she thought she could manipulate the situation, get more money from the people. I don't know. No, because she wasn't, like, asking for money for anything. So, I think she was just, you know, trying to stay. I think she was just trying to stay. Yeah, like the time that people sent Rev the spicy hot pizza. I've been so horrendously bullied online. Oh, really? How? I got sent a lot of Wendy's Baconators without the bacon. Oh, okay. Oh. And it always goes back to, you're bullying someone with Asperger's. You're bullying someone with autism. And that's all I have to say. Just you can't use it as a shield. You can't use it and expect people to not treat you the same way that they would treat other people. A lot of people treat you the way that they treat you because you've done some really fucked up shit. A lot of people treat you the way they treat you because you're quick to rage and it's funny. Perry Caravello makes money doing it. Yeah, he does. Perry makes decent living, you know, being fucked with.
The worst trolls got banned, so they banned together the worst trolls to create even more disgusting subreddits than the King Cobra JFS one, which got banned. And the main one got banned, and that's why they're all scared shitless, and they've made all the other King Cobra ones that didn't get banned privated. And they're mad as hell that their main troll subreddit got banned. And I don't go out of my way to fucking harass my trolls or try to get them kicked out of the apartments they live in or scare off chicks that they're talking to, because I don't care. I don't fucking care. I'd rather make my wine and make my wands. And just do my thing. So it's not enough that the trolls got to get me kicked out of my apartment with the nonstop harassment. They're trying to break me and Jessica, which is bullshit. And then on top of that, they see one of the Talking Tom videos that I've made roasting these assholes who've bullied me nonstop for 10 plus years. And they flag it for sexual content and or nudity. And what does YouTube do? YouTube gave me a 2-week strike because.
But did you try to appeal? If it was really flagged for sexual content and nudity, you could have appealed it. If it was flagged for harassment and bullying, though, your appeal probably would not go through. Depending on what you said in that Talking Tom video. Hey, Squiz Squad. Don't think I've seen you here before, but welcome. It's lovely to have you. I hope you're having a wonderful day. He does care. He's seething. Yes. And whenever he does care, he always gets stuck in a loop about it. And he just loops constantly. Boglum Chronicles, you could leave out the spitting. And Boglum's not going to do that. It's part of the Cobes aesthetic. hey, Graveyard Flowers. Do we have a demon baby yet? We do not have a demon baby yet. Not yet. I still get the feeling that it's coming, but not yet.
We're Talking Tom video. You know the app I'm talking about. I just think it's fucking funny how, and then this is the thing of it. My trolls are going to bitch because they go 2 weeks without content. They're going to throw a huge fucking fit and go, well, it's not fair. It's not fair. We don't have anything to make fun of Cobra for 2 weeks. And if you think that fucking irks you, my YouTube fans are not going to be too happy 2 weeks without posting videos.
I am in the living room spectrum. You can quit with the Wi-Fi dropping. Come on. Get it together. Ugh. I'm never allowed to move. The puppy has decided to plop her small ickle head on my lap and snooze. Oh, puppy. But that's the thing. The trolls are still going to have stuff to make fun of. Because you're over on Facebook. And your Facebook is public. And anyone can watch your Facebook lives. They can even watch them after the fact. Or, you know, pull them and edit them and make them into digestible content. A la Boglum Chronicles. And so, you're not winning against the trolls or anything. You're providing them more. You're giving them more content.
Videos. Because it's not enough, you gotta harass my girlfriend. You gotta get me kicked out of my apartment. And then when your little subreddit page gets taken down, you throw a little bitch fit. And then, oh, so to get even, you fucking mass flag my YouTube channel. And that Talking Tom video gets flagged for sexual content. I rule my troll's sad fucking lives, dude. Holy shit. My YouTube fans are sending me screenshots of these fuckers freaking out on social media because they're not getting their way. Wham.
Darn, I thought his and Jessica's kind breed and spawn quickly. Incubation time must be longer. Yeah, unfortunately it is. It's a bit of a bitch, isn't it? But your trolls aren't really, like, raging online over this. If anything, it's more so, aw, damn, the subreddit's gone. That fucking sucks. Now what? That's it. Just, now what? Oh, hey, we can go and request to join the private Cobes subreddits and keep fucking going. Wow. It's almost as though it finds a way. Also, people have been going over to the farms and doing stuff there. You don't rule your trolls' sad, pathetic lives. If anything, the trolls rule yours, dude. And that's sad. That is sad. Bit pathetic. Let's be real. If Cobes and Jessica had a baby, would it be Tony? Oh, no. That's a genuinely horrible thought. Does he think it takes forever to make a new sub? Like, they'll just make a new one. Yeah, and there's a few that are still up and going that all they did was put it on private. And when you put a sub on private, you just request to join. And the mods can pick and choose who they let in. Reddit's really simple. Very, very easy concept.
Because it's not enough that they're trying to get Jessica to break up with me, which, you know, it is what it is. Hopefully it doesn't happen. They got me kicked out of my apartment by harassing the conquistadors nonstop. And honestly, I just want to say thank you to the staff and the management here. You shouldn't have to put up with it. And to the new owners, you inherited a beautiful apartment complex. And I'm sorry you have to put up with this. It's not your fault. And I want to make this goddamn video public on Facebook. And fuck what anybody has to say about it, dude. Hold them band together and mass flag my YouTube channel. Now my YouTube channel, because of a Talking Tom video, says I can't post videos for 2 weeks. That doesn't affect me, dude. All that does is make people pissed off at the situation even more. All my fans are going, oh, fuck no. I don't want to go 2 weeks without a Cobra video. No.
Again, you really seem to care. Because this is the fourth time you've said it. Fifth time, maybe. In 8 minutes. A video? I don't care. It's nothing to me. Well, you're on Facebook talking about it. Like, Cobes. We can see right through you, dude. We can seize it. Cobes and Jessica had a baby boy named Tony, and years in the future, this baby boy made a time machine to escape Satellite Man in the far-flung past. But there is no escaping Satellite Man. Oh, man. The thing about time travel that people don't really bring up is the fact that if you could time travel, like, you wouldn't. Because there are so many changes in things like diseases, bacteria, things of that nature, that if you were to travel back in time, or even forward in time, you run the risk of introducing something new and horrifying that they don't know anything about, or contracting something old and horrifying that had been eradicated. Also, if you were to try to eat the food, you would get dangerously, probably deathly sick. So while time travel in theory is fucking awesome, in practice, it would be a shit show. Hey, Red Eye. I'm fairly sure Cobes is salty as fuck. If he did not care, there would be no vid. Fuck off, Josh, and own your shit. Yeah. Josh, instead of making videos on Facebook, why don't you focus on, I don't know, packing? Focus on packing. Literally and figuratively speaking. Yeah, it'd be a shit show, both literally and figuratively. Did you time travel and eat an egg? No! I did not time travel and eat an egg. It was just a bad duck egg. That's all it was. And it took me the fuck out. So did that hill. It was just, it was a bad couple days, okay? I can't help it. I also somehow bruised my hand yesterday. I don't know how, but I have this nice big bruise on my palm. It's too bad you didn't duck the bad egg, Mano. Ah. Pack, you know good and well, troll, that Papa Nips is paying folks to pack Jorp's crap. He should be responsible for packing his own crap. I was just looking at his room. How long before he's got to be out of there? I am unsure. I am completely unsure. Also in Puff's corpse will be found. Oh, yes. R.I.P. Puff. Yeah, people are speculating that it's somewhere under the couch.
All my children might be laughing at this video right now, like, ha 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 ha. Done, you know. On thunder, and that's not a good thing. People are gonna get real fucking sick and tired.
Oh my god. Hold on, you guys. The Wi-Fi dipped. Bitch, I am in my living room. Quit it. Yes, Puff Puff passed. R.I.P. Puff. R.I.P. Puff. The egg travel time targeting Mango. It's the big duck conspiracy. Is Cobes moving back in with Clint? Oh, are we about to be getting some father-son vids with Clint himself? No, we are not. So Jessica has confirmed that Josh is getting a trailer. There's no way that Papa Nips would let him back in the house. Absolutely no way. Look, I choose to believe Cobes got picked up by some... Not Cobes, Puff. Okay. I choose to believe Puff got picked up by some old lady thinking he was a scaly kitty. He's living his best life somewhere. That is a nice thought. That's a lovely thought. I want to believe that, too.
On YouTube are getting treated, and YouTube claims to be a website about we don't tolerate bullying. This is exactly the problem with allowing a computer to police YouTube. What the fuck did I say earlier on my fucking channel? Exact proof of it, dude. I've been like kicked out of and harassed out of a lot of places. And nobody wants to deal with it, so their solution is just to kick me out. But then,
are the trolls the reason that you got kicked out of various bars for harassing women? Are trolls the reason that you admitted to going out to bars with no underwear on so that you can rub your erection against unsuspecting women as you walk by them? I don't think trolls are the reason for that. I also don't think trolls are the reason for you getting fired from jobs. so. Yay, then Coz will be trailer trash. Or is that an insult to trailer trash? That's an insult to anyone that, like, lives in a trailer. Because, the amount of trash that lives in trailers is actually relatively small compared to the number of normal people that live in trailers. Maybe Cobes will get a trailer. Maybe Cobes will get a new apartment. But one certainty is that he has sauce on his pants, god damn it. did he show that on stream? Him doing that to women? No. He actually just full-on admitted it. He just full-on admitted it. Can we indeed confirm he is still proud of his graph? Yes, we can confirm he is.
Look at this graph!
He is quite proud of that graph. Did you look at it? It's a graph. If he is going into a trailer park, some of those places are stricter than apartments. It'll be interesting to see if he isn't yeeted from a trailer park. That will be interesting to see because a lot of times, a lot of people don't know this, but in trailer parks, some trailer parks offer like rentals, but others have places that you can just flat out buy. You can buy the trailer. But you have to rent the lot that the trailer is on. Some lot rents include things like garbage, water. You still have to pay for your own electricity. And if you were to be removed from the trailer park, if you were to break the terms of renting out that lot space, then your options would be to hire someone to move your trailer to another location or sell it, either through the park or through a realtor. Pick it up, put it back down. Yes, if you're drinking a beer or anything from a can, you pick it up, you put it back down. Pick it up, put it back down. Pick it up, put it back down. But can he Lidl? Can he? I'd say yes. I'd say yes on the Lidl. Did you see the vid I sent you of the cat biting naked and laughing in the mouth and drawing blood? I didn't get a chance to because the subreddit got banned. The fucking subreddit got banned like 2 hours after you sent it to me. Gotta fucking love it. First trailer I lived in, we rented both the trailer and the lot. Second trailer I lived in, we owned the trailer and rented the lot. Yeah. Trailer Park Cobes. And he's Bubbles. Do you think Cobes' new place will have a hot tub? And will it have two bros? Oh, two bros like this?
Two bros chilling in the hot tub, 5 feet apart, because they're not gay.
They're not gay. You heard it here. It could probably smell the burgussy on her breath. Oh, user two, no.
They go home after a long day of work. Or just doing their thing, they get Power Media too. And nobody does anything for them. And then what? You know what I'm saying? Then they're the ones bitching because it's not fair, online bullying, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's so typical our society, man. Like a 2-week ban from YouTube isn't going to affect me. All it's going to do is piss off my fans. My trolls are fucking stupid. You would think after the main server that got deleted that these people would wake the fuck up and go, fuck with the King Cobra, get the fangs.
No, it's more like fuck with Reddit TOS, get shut down. What? How long before the first trailer fire because this nitwit passes out drunk with a lit cig? Or worse, a grease fire. You know what's coming. I do. I'm gonna give it like a month. A month. Gonna go out on a limb. A month.
Oh, hey, the subreddit that we've had for like several fucking goddamn years just got deleted. That maybe we should back off of Cobra. What we're doing should be super illegal. Nope. So, yes, as of now, I have a 2-week ban. For what, you may ask? Like I said, using the Talking Tom cell phone app to make fun of my YouTube trolls, the same assholes who scare off every girl I try to talk to, or who harass me at my jobs till I get fired, and they harass apartment complexes that I frequent or live at because they want to get me kicked out. These people are fucking assholes. And the only thing that pisses me off my trolls more than anything is the fact that I just continue to make videos. I continue to make videos. I don't gotta fucking bully them out of the chicks that they like or harass them with their job or their family or get them kicked out of their apartment to fuck with them. You know what I'm saying? And like, literally.
Where did he work? Back in the day, he worked at a Wendy's. Yeah. Worked at a Wendy's back in the day. Funny thing about the move, all this furniture is infested with roaches and other bugs. They're going to move all that. The chair bug saga continues. Yes. The chair bug saga will indeed continue. And it's gonna be fucking gross. And that once you get those types of bugs, especially in trailers, it's very hard to get them back out. Sup, Tubes. They had a Boar's Head sample booth in the hallway today. Hawaiian roll, chipotle chicken, Havarti with a garlic aioli sauce. Would have been better with some crunch Doritos, maybe, but... They all talk like that random small child who drops tea while getting a drink at the playground. You know, while they're gulping juice, just my dad naked wrestles with other dads. Oh my god. Kids will say the wildest things. And you also have to be really careful about what you say or do in front of kids, because their minds will simplify it. And so when they say it out loud to, like, their kindergarten teacher, it sounds really weird. And usually gets a phone call going, hey, can you clarify something? I have a friend that worked in a pharmacy, and her child told their teacher that their mommy sells drugs for a living. She works in the pharmacy. They're prescriptions.
The truth. Girls will sit there and bully me out of the apartment complexes I live in. All I gotta do to piss them off is use a cell phone app with a cat that, like, copies everything that you say. So like you can record yourself making Talking Tom talk the most biggest amounts of shit, and it's hilarious. And there's nothing you can do about it. That's just the nature of the game, Facebook. But I'll catch you later.
Thank you again to Boglum Chronicles. Also, if that's just the nature of the game and there's nothing you can do about it, why'd you go on for so long about it? Cobes cares. Cobes deeply, deeply cares. So, thank you, Cobes and Boglum Chronicles. Let's see. Why don't we? Because I do have an old Shanny video for us. So, let me present to y'all the Shanlets. While I pull this up. Hooray for Shanlets. Thank you again, Frank. They are wonderful. So, this video of Shanny's comes to us from way back in the day. This is way back in the fucking day. And she sounds really drunk in this, so let's see what's up.
Now, hello. Now, there's certain people wondering what I'm doing at the moment, because I haven't made a video in a few days. Well, it's pretty simple. Pretty simple. With these groups of individuals, and you know who you are as a group of individual, you have pissed me off to the point of I don't want to have anything to do with you at this time. It's simple as.
All right, so there's a group of individuals who are being individuals in a group that she is just pissed off with. Okay, cool. How'd they piss you off, Shanny? Couple hundred pounds ago? Yes, CT, a couple hundred pounds ago.
Zach, I can't mentally, physically, or even verbally set my eyes and put my mouthpiece or type to any of you guys. Because.
Put your mouthpiece? Put your mouthpiece. Every individual is a group of one if you really don't think about it. Fair, Brandon. That's fair. Then why are you on the inner tubes? Good question. Great question, Jinyu. And definitely a few teeth ago. Also, hello, 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 Fit and Curvy. It's lovely to see you, darling.
You have really been completely narcissistic, mean-spirited jerks when I didn't even do anything. You listened to someone who threatened me and my husband, and you let your imagination take over and accuse me of things that are not even true. And because of this, and because of the constant berating and the constant naysaying and the constant dissenting points of view, I just don't want to deal with it because I'm trying to stay in the positive and not go into the negative. So
then why are you drunk? If you want to stay in the positives, why are you so drunk? She looks like she stepped out of an old Dutch painting of a peasant. Hey, QTC, how you doing today? Like, if someone pisses me off, generally I go, hey, look, I am upset, and this is why I am upset with you at the present moment. It's really simple. It's an easy thing to do.
To be fair.
She could be high. I don't think so. This has the speech pattern of a drunk Shanny.
Oh, if you wonder why I'm not even talking to you group of individuals that you know who you are, then you would understand clearly what I am going through right now. And I don't think I should talk to mean-spirited people. The Bible tells me I should avoid people like you. Because your contentions and you're trying to make strivings and arguments and debate me over stupid things that I'm not interested in. I'm not interested in evolution. I'm not interested in your stupid theories. I'm not interested in your science. Sorry, I'm not interested in that. I used to be interested in that until I found out through many years of research that most of it is all BS, and I'm just taking what man says as the vital truth, men in laboratory coats, when
the men in laboratory coats are educated. They're educated. That's the big thing. They're educated. I handle my emotions like an adult. I bottle them up and cry myself to sleep at night. Fair. I too do that from time to time. The Bible? Yeah. The Bible is her truth. Well, it exists whether you believe it or not. No, yeah, but she's not going to believe it. Men in lab coats built the camera and mic you're using. Well, look, she doesn't trust them. Okay? She does not trust them. They are not educated. They are learned, according to Shanny. Yes, that's right. Ugh.
They do the things they do and says this is a flex so they can get money in their pockets from corporations who just want to push an agenda. But see, you don't want to believe that because you are brainwashed in the head through the same media, the same corporations who are trying to push these agendas.
And Christians aren't trying to push an agenda? At least, you know, like, the bad Christians aren't trying to push an agenda? Because the bad Christians are most definitely trying to push an agenda. Do I hear a cat? Yes, you do hear a cat. Cat concert. I don't think it's watermelon. This is back when she was married to Chris. This was back when she was married to Chris. No one listens to. Yeah, they are. But no, this is way back in the day.
Because they put it in a nice, pretty, what the heck is wrong with my hair? Whatever, I don't care. It's hot out. Anyway, they like to put it in a nice, pretty package, and they talk really nice to you in the schools, and they talk really gentle to you, and they make things look so amazing, like, we're gonna go to the moon and space travel, and they said, been saying that since the 1920s, and, who's been in space? Oh, right. The people who are trying to propagate these lies to you.
What? Who the fuck else is supposed to go to space? Random people that don't know anything about how to travel in space? The people that go to space are the people that are educated and know what they're doing. Sometimes I forget just how long she has been stupid. Just how long stupid shit has been coming out of her mouth. I actually have a pain in my back now. So she never feeds her cats then. I don't know if that's the cry of I want to be fed or if it's a cry of I'm in heat. Because if it's a female cat, she might be in heat. I'm unsure. Okay, is the next thing she will say be the earth is flat? She does believe the moon is a hologram. So you never know. Look at that freaking smug got you face. Yeah. Yeah, she got us. Pretty is not a term anyone would associate with Shani ever. No. Only thing that changed is Shani became a star in her own mind and gained enough weight to be considered a planet. Mango's got pain in her back. God damn it. Yeah, I do. God damn it. And there's no oxygen in the water. Yes, she does believe that there is no oxygen in the water. Water has no oxygen. Despite the fact that it's literally H2O, O meaning oxygen, there's no oxygen. I would say that Shani was pretty in high school. Yeah. She looked all right in high school. Don't know what the fuck happened, but...
But you still want to believe it. It's amazing. It's so amazing. We've seen Pluto again, a rock. Even though, really, if you actually look at, you know, pictures of the Earth or look at pictures of planets, they have a certain Photoshop computer-like image quality to them. It's almost like they took a photo lens, right? They put another lens over it, and you just get, look at my eye. Let me do this eye so I'm not like Illuminati. It's like they just put like a yeah, you just get that. You see what's in the hole of my hand? You just get that point of view. That's kind of how it looks. You know, everything looks rounded.
everything looks like it was taken by a camera. Also, the planets are round. So, yeah, they're going to look round in a photo. They're round. How many science classes did you ever pass? For fuck's sake, yeah. She's really stupid. The level of stupid she is surpasses a lot of things. Yep, Flat Earth Shani. Let's send Shani and Rev into space, see how they fare. Says someone that has never looked through a telescope. Shake my head. Yeah, she hasn't done much of anything.
When you put a circle over it and black it out, right? So, you're believing that bullcrap when you really don't really know what certain things are, but you assume it is because you were taught that in school. Instead of using common sense to figure out what reality truly is and actually being the scientist and skeptic in which you claim to be. You look at the government as they're the good guys trying to fight for the best, fight for freedom, even though the countries America invades are oil rich and full of artifacts that the occult would love to get a hold of.
Full of artifacts that the occult would love to get a hold of. They're full of artifacts of history, of human history. They're artifacts of the history of the planet. Archaeological digs aren't there for the occult. Archaeological digs are there for the history. Anthropologists work closely with archaeologists for the history. Oh my fucking god. I don't know how much more of this video I can take. This hurts. This is painful. What the fuck are you on about, Shani?
You trust these people who don't do anything good for the economy or the American people, but you trust them, and you're like, voting is wonderful, but yet the people you vote for gets worse and worse. Well, I could vote for the lesser of two evils. Why would you want to vote for evil, period? So,
because unfortunately, Shani, we live in a two-party system, and well, your best bet is the lesser of two evils. Oh, God. The stupidest strong with this one. It is. It's very strong. Archaeological digs are where we find remnants of the past, and the Shani Rev excavate ancient yeast species not seen in over 1,000 years. Oh. Fair. Hold on, Mango. Shani might be cooking something. Drain damage. Come on, Mango. You're halfway through. You can power through. I don't know if I can. What did I wake up to? The stupidity, Reaper. Absolute stupidity. Wow.
Your mind is completely warped and brainwashed. You don't think clearly because you believe what every other person has to say instead of just being like, well, it should be this way. but it's not this way. How does that make sense? You know, and then you say God isn't real and Satan isn't real, even though the people that are controlling the media and controlling the government all put homage to an image called Satan. But yet you want to trust these people who worship Satan? Satan told the truth in the Garden of Eden. Really? Are we really gods? We're dying. We're not immortal, even though Adam and Eve were immortal, but they didn't want to stay that way, so.
And you believe that, Shani. You believe that. You believe that they were immortal until they ate the fruit. But you don't believe in evolution. You don't believe that the planets have been seen from space. You don't believe in space travel. Okay. When you come to a mango stream, you're either going to have a headache or want to puke. That's very true. My stream should not be like that. Claims require evidence, dumbass. Yes, yes, they do. And her claims, her only evidence is a book. One book.
You're trusting in a serpent. You don't know it because you're too blind by everything that you try to look at, and you don't put two and two together, and it's just to the point where it's like, why bother dealing with delusional people who don't want to listen to common sense? You say there is no God, but everything seems to have a significant design to it. You know, everything has a certain perfection to it, even though, you know, it's amazing. You can look at our bodies, for instance, and how did that stuff just randomly happen? Even scientists says there's a design to stuff. Even Richard Dawkins says there's a magnificent design to this creation, and we're called creatures, which means if we're creatures, you know, it comes from the word created, so ergo creation.
What? What? Watchmaker apologetic bullshit. Yes. Yes. So there's perfection and a design to the Cheeto dust on my shirt. Yes. Yes, there is. Is she drunk? Yes. Yes, she is. She's so fucking bad at this. Yeah. Yeah. Bitch, what? Bitch, I don't know. Mango, why? I wanted an old Shani video for today. I didn't know what I was getting myself into or going to be forcing y'all through, and for that, I apologize. Oof. I'm so sorry.
You look, yeah, human beings, and you see a significant difference from us from the other animal kingdom, but yet you think it just randomly happened that we became this intelligent. And then you're so egotistical that you think anyone who has a different point of view is stupid, even though you're the one who's believing things that you're told, because that's what secular education is about. It's not about experimentation and actually trying to conceive what this thing called life is. It's about this is it this way, and it's this way, and it's going to be this way. See, that's why you get tested, not by how you can use your brain and try to figure things out, but more of what you know.
Girl, you went through the secular education system. The fuck are you on about? What? I don't... Look here, listen. I, for one, believe that standardized testing is just a way to prove that you're able to memorize concepts. But it's how you use these concepts to experiment in this thing called life. Should critical thinking skills be taught in school? Yes, absolutely. Are they? Not always. It just depends on, like, where you grew up at. But, Jesus, fuck, woman. Shut the fuck up. Oh, my God. Does my head hurt too? Yes, it does, user two. Yes, it does. And my back is hurting even more.
Which, for me, I think that's not education at all. That's indoctrination. But you don't want to look at it that way, do you?
Because it's not indoctrination. We're indoctrinating kids to know math, learn basic science concepts. Learn how the branches of government work. Like, what? Okay, that's it. I'm tapping. I can't do this. I tap out of this. I can't do it anymore. I tried. I tried so hard. I got so far, and in the end, Shani's fucking stupid. I can't. Okay. We're gonna clear our minds for a second. And then we're gonna watch Kate cook something. She alleges she learned it in England. But I can guarantee you she did not. So let's watch. Here, we'll watch this.
It takes years to hone the skills of debate. But who the fuck has time for that bullshit?
Fights of nature during predetermined things that you have no control over, but there's also no God, so it doesn't matter.
Forge your own path.
You kind of are retarded.
With Bravo de Cristo School of Master Debating.
I am just obeying the physical quantum mechanics of my nature. Oh! Emil Ergus, did it to himself? We're all impersonal entities with no free will or consciousness of our own. We're just acting in accordance with natural law. Oh.
Fuck traditional debate skills.
Cause, oh yeah, I got one over on Nick Bravo.
Stink!
I know exactly what's going on.
Flourish them with nonsensical machinations.
Oh, you're so wonderful, and you have so much power and courage. Oh, you are a Marine!
And that means I have the right to treat people like shit. Me.
I'm a veteran, see everybody? Veteran. You have to be nice to me. You have to respect me.
Don't give a fuck!
Yep, I agree. Oh, the world is ending. Look at me roll my eyes. It doesn't matter.
Sonia Kaufman. Desecrate my images of veteran.
Bravo de Cristo School of Master Debating. Lifting hearts, minds, and fat folds since 2023.
I'm a good person because I'm a veteran.
Needed that. Mango, do you have a favorite Shani video or moment? I really enjoyed the key fob saga. Ooh, that's a great question. I've really enjoyed all of the body cam footage. I have deeply enjoyed all of the body cam footage. The underpants gnome is angry. Yes, he was very angry. He was big mad. I don't know this dude, but I'm going to immediately take anything he has to say as fact. That's fair. That's fair. He owned a convertible Mustang and not a cool one. And he cruised car parks for chicks because he is Nick fucking Bravo. Alright, so. Let's watch Kate cook something that she says she learned in England, but I doubt. And we're starting off short. Beans. Okay. Barbecue sauce? Barbecue sauce. You learned this in England and it contains barbecue sauce? Ketchup, mustard, and smiley face French fries. Okay. All right.
Okay, this is so yummy. This is Little Smokies.
Her voice always annoys me. Small human subliminal messaging. slap some pickles on it. Hold on.
Pickles. 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 Pickles.
Yeah, just the one face is upside down. Just the one face. Just that one, right in the front, is upside down. None of the other ones are. And that's throwing me the fuck off. She tosses olive oil on everything. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Soccer Mom Easy Bake Oven Smileys. Also titled, How to Ruin a Cookie Sheet.
Beans with some flavor on top and some potatoes. So this is, I learned this while I was in England. This is like a classic English breakfast, but just a little Americanized with these smiley face potatoes.
It's a classic English breakfast to have Little Smokies, beans, barbecue sauce, ketchup, and mustard. Now, I think that a classic English breakfast that tends to happen is beans on toast. And the thing about the beans that they use over there, they're not sweetened the way that beans here are. They have Heinz brand beans. but they're certainly not barbecue
beef. It may be seasoned just a little differently, but wow, doesn't that look amazing? They're so cute. I love how uniform everything is. I love it. Oh, these have the perfect cook on them, if I do say so myself. And if you listen, can you hear that? So good. Oh, it's so beautiful. I love these little smiley faces. They are perfectly cooked. This is in the oven for about 25 minutes. So let's get into it. Perfect English breakfast. I like to use a little spatula. And again, okay, one of the things I didn't talk about, the best part about this is I'm not going to have to clean this pan. I'm just going to simply lift up this parchment paper when I'm all done. And look, it's going to be perfectly clean. But let's get into my English breakfast straight away. And I like to do one or two smiley per guest. Can you hear it sizzling? I love it. So, look at that. So that's your breakfast. Potatoes, English breakfast. I don't know why English people like to eat their breakfast like this, but...
They don't. Bitch, they don't. The English decidedly do not eat their breakfast like this. What? Whoever told you that is fucking with you. They have to be fucking with you. What guest? Kate, no one comes to your house. They've seen your videos.
Pretty great. And then again, when you're all done, it's all served up. Just going to show you. Grab gently as to not burn yourself. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, it won't let me pick it up. But look, all clean. Terrific. Enjoy this breakfast. This is like a savory breakfast. So much protein. And the little smiley faces to make everybody's day brighter.
Oh. Well, Red Royals, you walked in on the end. And she made an English breakfast. With little smoky wieners, beans, barbecue sauce, ketchup, mustard, smiley face fries on top that she drizzled in oil and covered in pepper. And she said it's the great English breakfast. She doesn't know why the English eat their breakfast like that, but, you know. Yeah. Yep. As someone who lives in England, that is not an English breakfast. You know, I was thinking that. I was thinking that. All right, you guys. I'm going to call it here. My back really does hurt like a shit ton. So tonight, it's Wednesday night. So tonight over on Underhaven's channel, they are going to be talking with one Mr. Todd Malicote. So be sure to go check that out. Tomorrow night, Hian is doing CSB. And Hian will be doing a book review of Dave's latest book. Yes. It will be Lord of Patriarchy's latest book. So be sure to go check that out. Friday night, the doors of the sanctum will be open. So go check them out. And of course, tonight at 5:30, Slim will be going live on his channel. It is Wednesday, so it should be Drunk News Report. Saturday night is Underhaven, because I know words. There will be no brunch this weekend, but I will probably do something Sunday morning before I have other things that I need to do. And yes, Bran is also streaming later doing, I assume, the Cow Corral. So, yeah. lots of lovely things going on. As always, in the description, there's links to the stream perfs I'm on the shared stream yard with, links to the Petty Fam, Tito and Yato, Tito's Funnier Than Yato. There's Mango's master list of U.S. resources. There are links to Small Human stuff, so be sure to check that out if you so choose. Yeah, I'm going to go rest a little bit, and then I need to wash dishes. So I hope that y'all have a fantastic rest of your day, and even better tomorrow. And I will see y'all on the next one. Bye, guys.